That's right. The AG says it'll cause confusion, but those local leaders say they're just trying to keep their citizens safe. Texas Congressman Lance Gooden joins us now to weigh in. Sir, thanks for being here. It does seem like this would cause confusion, is it?
It does. The state has basically said restaurants, businesses, they have the choice of whether or not to open up. But the municipalities, the cities, they don't have that choice. They have to let them do it. And in liberal cities like Austin, you've got mayors who are just drunk on power. They've got their plastic bag bans. They've got homeless roaming the streets and have said that they can sleep anywhere on the sidewalks. And they love implementing policy that would never, ever pass in the state house. And that's what we have here. We have these local leaders issuing their own directives, and the governor is just looking out for them, and so is the attorney general, and I'm grateful to them both.
Yeah, let's look at the back and forth here between the state and Bexar County, which is where San Antonio is. Here's the letter from the attorney general to that county. Bexar County and the city of San Antonio has issued a local public health order that exceeds the county's lawful authority. Act quickly to correct mistakes like these to avoid further confusion and litigation challenging the county's unconstitutional and unlawful restrictions. Now, here's the mayor of San Antonio right back saying, on the merits, we're not concerned. But it doesn't stop the AG from seeking a cheap political headline. What exactly was San Antonio and Bexar County doing to overstep their ground?
Well, I can't speak to that county, but I can speak to the city of Austin, because I suspect it's similar down in San Antonio. Austin was saying, if you're a restaurant and you're opened up, we want you to keep tabs on who comes in. We want you to keep a log, ask for contact information of your patrons that dine there. And then if you don't do that, then we could potentially shame you with the health commission. Those were things that the city leaders were saying, you know, we're in compliance, but they failed to mention directives like that that they were issuing. That was in Austin. I don't know the situation in Bexar County, but I suspect it's something similar. Mm-hmm. We're not just talking about confusion, saying, hey, you're telling your citizens to wear masks, but it's really not required, and you can't lock anyone up or fine them for it. We're talking about underhanded tactics like forcing restaurants to keep these tabs on patrons. No one's going to go to a restaurant and say, oh yeah, here's my address, I'll have the hamburger. And then you're shaming these restaurants and scaring them with threats such as, we'll put your name up and we'll make sure that the city knows that you're not following, the people in the city knows that you're not following protocol. It's stuff like that that the attorney general said, this is ridiculous, we've got to put this out. And I'll say, you know, we've got large cities. Not every city is acting this way. You go to the city of Dallas, I'm not talking Dallas County, but the city of Dallas, Mayor Eric Johnson, he's a Democrat, but he has made a point to say that this is not a partisan exercise for him. And he is following the law. He is doing what he should be doing. He's keeping citizens safe, but he's not going to war with the governor. You've got some other cities around the state. They just love to play politics. They want to enforce whatever they feel is necessary. Right. And they do it all, they say, in the name of science. And the governor and attorney general just looking out for the state and for restaurants and for people who want to go to those restaurants and make decisions for themselves.
Have you heard from any restaurant owners in Austin who have been frustrated by this?
I have. I've got friends in Austin. I haven't been to Austin in several weeks, but I've talked to people who have gone to these restaurants. None of them are complying with this directive to keep a journal of who goes and eats there, along with contact information. That's just not happening. But there are some that have chosen not to open. Some are doing it, and they're keeping it 25% occupancy. In rural areas, I've got a lot of rural areas in my district, it seems to be business as usual. The restaurants are not packed because a lot of people, senior citizens especially, are making the decisions for themselves not to come out. They want to stay home. They want to remain safe and not get out there. But the governor and attorney general and myself, we believe that people can make that decision for themselves. And the government doesn't need to tell people how to behave. We've been doing this for 2 months. We know what's serious and what's not. We know what risk that we and our families are comfortable taking at this point.
All right. Congressman, thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right.